All right, guys, welcome back. Great to have you guys back here. Before we get started, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. Today's video makes me remember my uni engineering days, gold old times, way before Instagram and TikTok. Today, we're gonna show you how to exactly calculate the range of your e-bike by a simple method, making you realize that those physics classes that I took were actually very helpful. It all starts with a very simple formula. Battery energy density, which is 48 volts pack on a 16 amp hour of energy. If you multiply voltage times amp, you get watts, and hour is always hour, so 768 watts hour. The norm, EN15194, is the norm that rules Europe, Australia, Brazil, and many other countries. This norm is the norm that has been killing cyclists here in Australia. To get this norm, you have to pay $250, man. You know, if they want everyone to follow the norm, why don't they make the norm readily available to anyone? No, you have to pay $250, so then you can follow the norm. Anyway, this norm that I completely disagree says that the bike has to have continuous output of 250 watts at 25 kilometers an hour. If you got this speed is pretty much a higher speed that you can average in your car traveling through the city and stuff. So this is a good estimate of speed. So what we do, we get this 250 watts and we're gonna divide the energy density of our battery pack, 768 watts hour, per 250 watts. So the calculation gives us, we divide 768 by 250, we cut watts with watts, and then we have only hours. 3.072 hours of use of this battery pack at 250 watts consumption. Oh, Felipe, you are ignoring the losses and everything. Yes, you know why I'm ignoring it? Because you have legs and you can pedal the bike, okay? We are considering only draining 250 watts, like controller draining the battery pack at 250 watts. If you divide energy density by 250 watts, we get 3.072 hours. If we consider that we are traveling constantly on a flat surface at 25 kilometers an hour, we're gonna have 76.8 kilometers of range. That means we're gonna be traveling at 25 kilometers an hour for 3.072 hours. So that's the best estimate I can give to my customers. Why? Some people don't pedal that much, other people are very sporty. And this range here is something that we can show the customers the speed they're gonna be traveling and what power they're gonna be consuming. Imagine, if I tell you that my car clocks 500 kilometers an hour, you're gonna think it's a great car. But if I tell you it takes 10 days to reach 500 kilometers an hour, you're gonna think, wow, Felipe, that's very bad, actually. Here, I can give you how much power you're gonna consume, you can read it on the dash, and at what speed you're gonna be traveling. And I'm ignoring that you are not pedaling, you know? So if you pedal and you can output human power on the pedals, probably you're gonna increase this range quite a lot, okay? So this is a very simple calculation. I don't know how any other stupid person hasn't put this on YouTube and talked to you guys about that, okay? So at Cyberbikes, how we calculate the range of our bikes. This is the formula and this is our standard. We give you the power consumption and we give you the speed you're gonna be traveling divided by the nominal voltage and amp hour of our battery packs. And we give you the precise range, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed it. Feel free to use it in your experiments and see you next time.